Hello and welcome everyone. I'm Kiran Rajput. Today I'm here to give a short presentation on Confluence. This presentation is divided into 5 sections: Introduction to Confluence, National Virtual Library of India Space on Confluence, Team Space for each individual team, Daily Worksheet Activity Sheet, Introduction to HipChat, and Question and Answers. These are the Confluence users worldwide: Microsoft, Accenture, Facebook. These are the users of Confluence. Imagine a working environment where you send very less emails, attend very fewer meetings, and still create better results. With Confluence, you can, where every team gets a space to create, share, discover, and discuss contents in the forms of files, meetings, diagrams, projects. This brings everyone together at one place. Now, what is Confluence? I hope everybody sitting here must be very curious to know what Confluence is and how Confluence will be helpful in our day-to-day activities. Confluence is a collaboration tool which provides storing, sharing, and storing contents. Confluence also organizes contents in the forms of documents, meeting notes, diagrams, etc. Confluence is a collaboration tool which provides idea into pages and content be created, and where you discover your own content and accessible to your team, and where you take action on your own work which you have created. This process is called a work collaboration cycle, where at the end everyone has a voice, information flows freely, and works get done. It has many different uses. It can be used as a knowledge management tool, a social communication, a website, a tool for planning agile development. The main benefits of Confluence are its flexibility and centralized repository of information. Additional benefits of Confluence are administrative features like permission schemes can be set up at different levels. We're moving to the next step is the space. Spaces are the collection of pages which have contents. Pages are contained within spaces. Next, moving to the is a space directory. Space directory is the list of pages that a user has the permission to view or edit. To go to the space directory, choose space, then space directory of the Confluence editor. As we click on the space directory, we see the all the space assigned to the users. The choose the space you are going to use the most. You can mark a star to the right of your space, which you are going to use it on a regular basis to make it appear under my space on the dashboard. You can also search any of the space. You can type a part name of the space in this filter list, and the related files will scroll down immediately. What are pages? Pages are the primary means of storing and sharing information in Confluence. Pages can be structured into page tree, which shows relation between them. You can add rich contents like images, videos, files, links, and macros to it. How to create pages? There are two ways of creating page. If you're creating a blank page, you can hit the create button on the Confluence header, or you can choose it from the template, a blank page. Once you have created a blank page, you will be on the Confluence editor. Confluence editor is where you can name, rename your page, add content to it, format and save it. You can add contents like images, videos, meeting notes, etc., and choose preview to see how your page looks like, and choose save. Page templates. Confluence comes with many of the page templates. A template is a predefined page that can be used as a framework when creating a page. Meeting notes, blog posts, file list, and many more are the templates we have in Confluence. Meeting notes are the easiest way to draft an agenda of an upcoming meeting. You can capture many of the meeting action notes in it, store it for the attendees once the meeting is over. Blog post is the easiest way to share an announcement or the status report among your team's member. Blog post can be engaging and it can be attractive too, like a page. File list is the list of file which you can upload it in it, all the list for your team members to view it. These are some of the templates. You can use it, any of it, as per your contents. Copy a page. If you need to duplicate the content of the copy, the easiest way is to copy the page. To copy a page, go to a page space and choose go to menu and choose copy. And you can copy the content of the file. Rename the page and make other changes in the body of the pages. Choose and save it. Editing a page. As you save your page, the page will be in view mode. To edit a page, you have to re-enter the editor and you can edit the contents of the page and you can choose save to it. Confluence automatically saves a draft of your copy when you are working on it. There are two ways to resume a draft copy. The first is resuming editing an unsaved page. For that, you have to go to the profile picture, click to it and choose draft. And you can choose the draft of an unsaved page and you can start resume editing to it. The next step is to resume editing an unsaved page. The next step is to, when you are adding a page to the same space, Confluence will automatically ask you whether you want to resume the editing of an unsaved page. So you can resume editing or discard it. To delete a page, of its all versions, go to the page and choose go to menu and then choose delete, and you can delete it, that page. Also, please note the delete option will only appear if you have a permission to do so. If someone has given a restriction to that page, the restriction will prevent you in deleting the page. To delete a specific version of a page, go to the page and choose go to menu, then go to page history, and you can choose the version which you wanted to delete it. Page restriction. Page restriction allows you who can view your page, edit pages in a space. Go to the page and choose the icon, page icon, restrictions icon, and you can apply over there viewing or editing restriction to it, who can view and who cannot view the page, and apply restriction to it. Move or reorder pages. While creating a page, choose the location icon at the top of your page. If you want to move your page to your parent locations or anywhere else to the other space, you can choose the location and you can shift your page and choose save to it. The other way is, like, in case if your page is already created, then choose go to menu and choose move. In case if you wanted to move the pages among the child pages, then you can use the tab on the left hand side of the set page locations icon to help you find this new space, and then you can click to the reorder and choose save to it. Add search for labels. Labels are tags that are useful to finding out your specific page. To add a label to a page, go to the page and choose the edit icon over here, and you can add your labels and choose add to it. Label and attachment. There are two ways of attaching labels to an attachment. First, go to the page, choose the go to menu, and then choose attachment. and you can attach it over there and a label. The other way is to choose this space and choose space tool here, then choose contents and click to the attachment. You are going to see all the list of attachments listed here. You can choose the label and save it, change the label and save to it. Search for labels. In case if you have any specific content, like you can search it by label text. In case if you are searching for any specific pages like annexures, you can type label text on this Confluence search field and the related pages you can see on it. Search by name. In Confluence, you can also search the document or file by name. In case if you are searching for any of the MOC files or MOC papers, you can enter in the Confluence search field and you can see all the related papers scrolling down. Next come the space sidebar. Space sidebar is the page tree. It's a hierarchical list of pages that you are going to find in Confluence. It's also like when you create a new page, by default you can see it in the space sidebar. Versioning, it maintains versions of the documents uploaded and page created. In case if you have made any of the changes in the documents and you have saved it, a new version will be created in it. How to view a version? Go to the space and choose go to menu and then choose the page history and you can view versions there. How to compare versions? Go to space and choose go to menu, then page history, and click to page history. We'll see the versions over here. You can select both the versions and compare, select compare versions here, and you can see all the versions. Next, coming to the dashboard. Dashboard is the front page of the Confluence site, which provide access to the information and information that are important to the users. It also the first thing that the user sees on logins. Dashboard can be accessed anywhere from the site logo of the Confluence header. This was the end of the introduction of Confluence. Moving to the next section is the homepage of NVLI. This is the homepage of National Virtual Library of India. We have uploaded all the documents here. NVLI related all the documents over here, which becomes very easy for others also to access the documents. This space is accessible to all the managers, including the partnering institute also. We'll do.
As per your request.
This is available to the all the partnering institute also, where they can upload their pages, view, edit in their respective pages. Moving to the next session is the team space. We have given every team a space where they can upload their documents. This is a private space to the team members. We have a team details here. You can upload all your team details of the members, which become very accessible to everyone to view and work on easily. We also have uploaded three pages like meeting notes and then reports and documents. In reports and documents also, you can upload all your related documents to it for your team to view it and work on it. This is the meeting notes. In case if you don't need the meeting notes, you can delete this and you can upload any of the templates, page templates, as per your contents. Daily workload report. As you are everyone aware that DocuWiki is no more functioning, so we have configured in Confluence so that everyone can update their daily activities. This is the NVLI coordinating team, where all the details of the members have been given in this. You can upload all your informations here, like employee code, designation, project titles, emails, contact number, everything here for an easy accessible. The next we have the work activities. In this template, we have already started putting all our activities here from July onwards. You can also follow this template as your wish. If you want, feel like using and some other templates, you can do also that. Suppose if anybody has recorded any of the work activities they have downloaded in any of the documents files, they can upload over here, like before June or before July, whatever activities they have done, they can record it over here. This was the end of the sessions. We are introducing a new features in Confluence, that's a hip chat. My colleague Yougansh will carry forward to it.
Thank you, ma'am. So, hello everyone. Most of you would have used Yahoo Instant Messenger in the past, right? And most of you all of you must be using WhatsApp. So, it's kind of a WhatsApp for office or a Yahoo Instant Messenger for office. Most of the features are same and some are different. So HipChat is a web service for internal or private chat and instant messaging. It has several advantages, like there is a one-to-one private chat conversation you can have on HipChat. There can be a group chat specifically for your team. You can create a two-person group, three-person group, and chat. Usually what happens, whenever you communicate through email, there is a lot of formal language. You draft the email in a very formal language and it usually takes time, right? So information does not flow very freely, and there is no faster feedback and information sharing. So here instant messaging provides us with this advantage that we, irrespective of whatever is the formal language, we can have an informal communication and get a faster feedback on certain things which we want to share among our team. So that can be done. Another thing is that we have created an individual spaces for all of your teams. So whatever activity you do within your space, those notifications can be configured to HipChat rooms. So like in Yahoo Messenger, there were different rooms. Similarly, here in HipChat, we can create dedicated rooms which can be set public or private for different purposes. So what we have done is we have created rooms in HipChat for each and every team. So if any change happens in the Confluence space of your team, then those notification and updates appear in the HipChat room, respective rooms. Here you can also share a lot of files. Your chat history is always searchable. There is an inline image viewing. So if a team, while the communication shares some images, you do not need to explicitly download it and view. There is an inline image viewing. So you can view it in the chat window itself. And another thing is that most of the email messaging systems are not very responsive. Here, HipChat is supported by most of the platforms for the desktop as well and for the mobiles as well. It's being supported by Android and iOS smartphones and tablets as well. So you can almost access HipChat from anywhere. It also integrates with many third-party services such as GitHub, MailChimp, Heroku. So for those teams who there may be some of the teams which are explicitly into the software development part. So there they can configure all their GitHub updates to a dedicated room in HipChat, and all the GitHub notifications will appear in that room. We have hosted HipChat on this URL. So we'll be sending email invites, and you will have to sign up and join your respective team's rooms, and you can start using HipChat. This is the very first screen you get to see when you log into your HipChat account. Then you need to click on Launch the web app. And when you log in, you get to see on the left to which all rooms you are connected with. So here, since I have logged in from the admin account, I get to see a lot of team, or else I will only get to see only to the team which I am connected with. As you can see, there is a lock appearing over here that it shows that this room is a private room. So only those members who have access or invites to that room will be able to join. So this is a scenario where I'm editing a meeting note in my Confluence space. You can see NVLI PMO team. This is the space name and this is the name of the page. Here I'm just editing something, and when I click on save, I get a notification in my HipChat room, an instant notification in microseconds. So here you get to see that who has updated the page, what's the page name, when the page was created by whom, and what is the name of the space. And here you also get the URL to the page where the change has happened. Now this is another major advantage of Confluence is that it facilitates or it provides a cross-team collaboration. So in order to provide cross-team collaboration here among all the DBP teams, we have created a space named NVLI at IITB documents. So here for each team, there are individual pages created. You can see this is the name of the space. This is the home page. And for each team under the page tree, there is a page being created. Here you can upload and share any documents or reports that you think must be shared among all the teams. You can always create, edit and share a page and do all the functions provided by Confluence, which are most of them are self-exploratory. Permissions. Now, since this space has access to most of the teams and all the team members and managers, we have restricted the delete permission from all the users so that to avoid any accidental damage, accidental deletion of file. And any activity performed in this page or in every page is being recorded and is being logged somewhere in Confluence. So we request that any mischief should not be done. Another thing is that whenever you create a page in any of the space in Confluence, do remember to choose the right parent page. For example, if you want to create a page, sub page under accounts team, so do remember to click on accounts team first and then create a page. But accidentally, if you create a page somewhere else other than your desired hierarchy, you can always choose to move it to the correct location. So, as I said, that we are facilitating cross-team collaboration, and so that we can share all the documents at one place. Even this presentation slide has been already uploaded under our team's page, NVLI project coordination team. So you can simply go and download these slides named Introduction to Confluence in the space named NVLI at IITB space. To all those members and teams who have the access to Confluence currently, they can all right away view this file. These are some of the references. There are many small features which are self-exploratory. So we suggest you to start using it and let us know if any customization or assistance is required. Other than that, we have received team member details from some of the teams to whom the access has been provided both for Jira and Confluence as per their requirements. For other teams, I request that as soon as possible, please send your team details so that we can provide your credentials and we can set up Confluence and Jira for you. Now, some of the teams are using Jira, some are not. So it's optional as per your team's requirement, as per your nature of the team. So I think most of the software teams might be interested. So one of the team, I think Blended MOOC team requested us Jira software setup. So we communicated them all the credentials and with the basic setup of the Jira. Other than this, if there is any query, we are now open to question and answer session. I know doubts may not generate as of now because none of you have gone through using the system actually. So you can start using it even if there is no doubt right now. And most of the doubts are not very typical, which may not be solved by you as individuals. So if you come across any doubt, you can always write us at nvli.iitb@gmail.com and we'll be happy to assist you and help you. Yes. So in Confluence, there is no storage limit for documents, okay? And in HipChat, there is a storage limit up to 5 GB of file sharing you can do.
Last time in Jira, we have faced many issues regarding the permission. So could you please explain in the details, just demonstrate how we can create, how we can set the permissions right now? You can do this.
Okay. The permissions are being already set. We have taken care of everything.
I will assign to someone. This will be given to the manager, which task is important, what permission I have to give to the someone. So that every time we will not call to the your team that this document is required and these are the permissions required.
Yeah.
So how we can set?
Right. So we understand your concern, sir, but like
question was specific to Confluence. So
you explained Confluence, how can we create a document? That would be better.
Yes, yes. So I will go through a live instance of the Confluence.
So you'll get an idea of what actually is being running. So this is my home page. Okay. Right now I have logged in as an admin account, so I will see most of the things. Okay. Yes. So as you can see, this is my homepage. Even you can, there are a lot of minor features which you can explore by your own. Like I have, for easier navigation, I have created this space and set as my homepage. So each of you can create your own page, or any space to which you have access, you can set it as your home page. So currently, there for the NVLI project, these many spaces are being created. This is specifically dedicated for the worksheet, logging worksheet, and these are individual private spaces for all the DBP teams, right? So the spaces which are relevant for us as DBP staff, I'll go through those spaces first. You can always choose to see a list of spaces through the space directory. So this is the very first space about which Kiran ma'am briefed all of us. So this space is shared mostly with the senior managers here, and all the NVLI partners, which are CDAC, IGNU, RRRLF, and NKN. Here, all those documents are uploaded.
And we can upload and
yes. So this, in this space, you cannot
create anything, because this space is being taken care by the admin, by the Confluence admins. Here you can always be updated about what communication is going on in the NVLI project. So here all those documents are uploaded, and here you have the view permissions. Other thing, this is the second space, which is for the cross team collaboration. Here, if you want to create something, you can go to your respective team. Okay, then you have to click on the create button. You get to choose so many page templates. Now, whichever page template is relevant to your team, you can choose that. For example, I'll choose the meeting notes. I'll click on create. By default, it takes the today's date, and I'll save it. Now I've got a template of meeting note. I can always choose to edit it, fill in all the details, like who were the attendees, goals. I need not to explain these all things, and then click on save. So all these things are saved for this document. Yeah. So we have avoided for you to set permissions. We have already set some permissions which we think that are sufficient for this space and this page. Okay. Now, if beyond that you need that this certain permission, I need as a manager or as a user, I need this permission, I need not be dependent on system admins for that, then you may write us for that, and we can provide you that permission. Like by default, you all the users do not have a delete permission. So in order to avoid the accidental deletion of any of the page or any of the documents. So similarly, there are other permissions as well. Sir, here, see, this space is specifically designed for cross-team collaboration. So here we need not to hide anything, right? So here, this space is dedicated for cross-team collaboration and sharing of the documents. Now, in case of individual spaces for your respective team, we have given all the access to you. You need not be dependent on us. So for example, if this is the space for eStudio team, right? Here, these are the permissions. I'll go through the permissions as well. So to start with, we have created only some three sample pages for you. You can always choose to delete them or add new to them. Meeting notes, reports, and documents, team details. So, ma'am, as you asked that how you segregate the project roles. So, here we have like eStudio team, we have categorized into three groups: eStudio managers, eStudio members, and eStudio assistant project managers. And sir, these are the permissions. Now, this space is dedicated for your team. So, you need not be dependent on the Confluence admins for any of the permission, right? So, here we have given you all the permissions that every user can view, every user can add or delete.
These permissions is universal permission. You can, cannot check for the documents independently. Each document.
Sir, these permissions
universal for your space and not beyond that. Under your space, for any of the document, you can choose to put access restrictions or you can provide access by your own.
I think what he meant, document, like suppose yes, only managers need to read, then if we give
not
a
read,
page
right, I want to give some permission
members,
for the writing
the
to someone.
The members will have a look to the manager document, right?
Okay.
So if only managers are, there are three managers, and only managers only have to view
Hello.
The document, then the team member should not give the
Hello.
Right.
Now these are not document specific access, then it might have some problem.
Right. So in that case,
make a specific a dedicated space for all the managers, and there you can upload or share documents, and within that space we'll give you the permission the access to set the permissions of that document or each document, right?
Suppose I have to create 10 documents today, then 5 tomorrow. Every time nobody will call to the PMO team that
no, sir,
this document is required, that permission.
Okay. I understood and I have proposed a solution to them. I will communicate
solution with you over the mail. That can be done.
So once you create a space, we don't need to contact you every time. We can just put in our documents and share among the managers in that way.
Yes.
So we'll be creating a dedicated space for managers. And there we'll be giving all the managers access to, put restrictions over a document or remove restriction over the document. And there, if we create a dedicated space, you even do not need a permission to put an access. Yeah. So there is a lot of customization possible, but see, since we have not started using the tool as of now, we do not know actually that what your needs are. So as you will start using it, you just communicate with us over the email or over the phone. We'll prefer email because then there is a record of what you have asked from us, and then we can customize it for you. If you want to see, I can also demonstrate how notification appears in HipChat. Totally optional. Yes.
So add and delete. So add means add and edit.
Yes.
Okay, but
I cannot.
Can I
segregate?
No.
Okay. So, no more questions. Yes.
My team members.
Yes.
So for logging the activity or the daily work log, we have created a dedicated space named DBP staff worksheet. Here, since I have logged in from the admin account, I get to see all the teams. But if you log in from your respective account, you will get to see only your team. So for example, this is the FRG team. And this is CERT's account. So here, since you have not provided access as of now, we don't have your team details. So we have created a template. Here you can choose to edit. Now this will be edited only by you. We have made sure that we have set all the permissions with respect to each individual users in this DBP staff worksheet space. So no other user can edit your actually timesheet. To start with, we took
where teams are present and what activities they are performing.
Yes, yes. I'll show you my work log.
So this is our Teams page. First of all, this page was to upload all the work log done before July 2016 if you have logged it some elsewhere. So I used to log it in a task sheet, so I uploaded that for July. Now this is we have by default created this template for you, but you may choose to use any other template as well. That's totally fine with us. This template is actually being used under agile methodology for daily stand-up meetings, wherein a user explains what he or she did yesterday and what he or she plans to do over the day. He or she enters this at the start of the day. Yeah. So this is the filled template.
Read
this. Yes, sir. I just want to know that
this person has created something.
He's talking about updates made by
users,
each team member in his team.
Sorry, can you repeat?
Updates of the team member. When this person logged in, what did he delete? What the log system generates?
Okay. Then actually I cannot
here, but I'll show that to you personally, because for that I'll have to show you the admin view.
Do not have that facility.
See, sir, one thing is that you want to
see the updates, whatever is being done in your space, right? So that appears over the homepage of your space under recent updates. Another thing is that you want to get notified.
People, 200 people, then you cannot see everything what they have done, no? You just want some high level view of what is happening and what is there a workflow mechanism which I can use?
Yes, sir.
Something has been done and then I can go ahead.
Yes, sir. Like, you can see.
This is the NVLI at IITB documents home space. Now, whatever activity is going on by each user, it is getting listed under recent space activity over here. When you scroll it down, you can see since the inception of this space.
Now can I club it and say that this is part of one activity?
No, I have not explored that actually.
Okay.
But
so for example, I list say 5-6 activities, and then the team member actually tags it with that activity.
Okay.
It comes under that, and when I want to see what is happening in that space, small activity space,
okay,
I should be able to get the status of it.
So I think, sir, if for this purpose, what I would recommend you is that Jira would be the most useful tool, wherein you can create each activity individually. You can set a time estimate for that activity. You can put in a start date, end date, and you can actually track the progress of that activity being done or being idle. And then there you can generate a timesheet report for each activity, for each user, and there are numerous filters which can be used to generate that report.
So whatever happens in Confluence, can this also be fueled back to Jira?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So even most of the teams, what they do is, some of the software teams, what they do is they when they create BRD or the SRS, they create that in Confluence. They have an informal communication. That document goes through various phases. Once it is fixed, when the BRD requirements are fixed, issues are being created right from Confluence to Jira, and then they are assigned to certain users.
So how do you create an issue here?
Yes. It's very simple actually.
Which space is this?
Yeah, I'll just. So I'm going in our team's space, private space. So I don't have any like meaningful example of creating an issue. But usually what happens is when we select a text, we get to see these two pop-ups. So you can see, is it viewable? When I select a text, so for example, if I have a BRD and that has been frozen, requirements are final. So I can just choose a particular text and I can click on create Jira issue. When I click on create Jira issue, it redirects, it opens me, it pops up the create issue screen, and I can create the issue in the project to which I have access in Jira. So it's as simple as that.
So are you giving Jira access to everybody?
Sir, it's on you. We are as of now giving access to everyone. And if you want to if you want us to conduct an hands-on training session on Jira for your team, we are happy to do that.
No, but if you give access to everybody, then people may use it, right? So let them use it and let them see how it works, because
yes, sir. By default, we have actually created dedicated projects in Jira as well,
right,
for each team, and they may start using that also. It's a single sign-on. Yeah,
I understand. Yeah.
So the user may just choose to switch into IITB Jira from here.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that. But like, there are teams of different nature, different work. There are some teams for them.
Workflows.
It may not be.
No, workflows are available.
Yes, workflows
or
are.
You can create a new one.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Even that can be done.
Right.
Yeah. I'm saying it's highly customizable.
So can
it's
you,
just that we need to know your requirements.
Can you do one thing? Can you send a document describing different workflows available in Jira?
Yes, yes.
Just send it to everybody.
I'll do share.
Let's see. I mean, who of them may use or may not use. So let them see how they can use it in their own.
Yes, yes. System. Most of the teams though use a default workflow in Jira, but
right,
there are numerous others that even those can be used. I'll share. I'll share it on the common space
right,
in the
right,
conference.
Right, yeah.
Yes, yes. So I'll just walk you through the Jira instance of Drupal vendors. They have been actively using Jira, and we have been using Scrum boards under Agile methodology for that development. So in the previous session, I covered that there is a Jira dashboard wherein you can use several gadgets and get to see all the reports in a summarized form. So this is how this is my personal dashboard which I have configured to track what's going in the Drupal development project. So you can see that this is the third sprint running, and there are only 2 days remaining. Taking a bit time due to slow connection, I don't know. This is a created versus resolved issue chart. So here you can see that I, as a user, I am being given access to all these projects created in Jira. So I'll open the Drupal NVLI project. Now 5 different vendors are constantly working and logging their issues, workloads in Jira here in this project. Yes. So you get to see, as this is the third sprint running right now, you get to see these many issues are being created and put into the sprint 3. Sprints are a time-bound iteration to do a task for those who are not aware about the sprint. You can see those issues which have been striked out, they are already complete, remaining are not are in progress. I'll show you how a issue typically looks like when we create it in Jira. And like I introduced HipChat, we have been using a similar software named Slack for all the communication for instant messaging here in this project. I'll show you that as well. Yeah, so this is a Jira issue. Now here you can see that when it was created, the creator put estimated time as 2 days. Later on, after completing this task, he logged the work as 2 days. This person is the assignee to which this issue was assigned, and he himself was the reporter. Here is his work log history, and all the status can be seen over here. So a lot can be done by Jira. Yes, sir. So this is a similar software for instant messaging dedicated for Drupal development. Now here for in order to receive a dedicated service request with respect to Jira and Confluence, for any doubts, all the vendors put their requests over here. You can see that this request was posted at today at 12:04 p.m. and it was resolved here. So actually, instead of writing mails, instant messaging software like this helps us a lot, and all the other discussions are being going on here. So here we call them channels, and there we call them rooms.
How do I get added on this? I'm also there on Slack.
Okay, you are also there on this URL, nvli.
No.
Okay, so actually this is dedicated for this Drupal development. So you may always request Professor Sundar, and he'll provide you the access for all these channels. So now I'll also show you how these Drupal vendors are being using Confluence for their communication and all sharing of the reports and all. So for easier navigation, our admin team have categorized these spaces under different categories. So when I click on Drupal NVLI, I get to see only those spaces which are related to the Drupal development teams. So as you can see, this is space Drupal NVLI docs. Now here they have all the architecture related discussion. They created this page, they have uploaded all the documents, annotation, store structure.
Is this available for everybody?
No.
No.
No. Only to the people who are associated with this development activity. Because it may not make any sense for other users. They are not. Similarly, like I said, that in sprint they have daily stand-up meetings every day, which is time-bound, and that is for 15 minutes. So this is how you can make meeting notes. So here they do make meeting notes on a regular basis and upload it here. Here they summarize it, everything, what was done yesterday, what will be done today, blockers if any, like that. So this is how it is being used. So it has got a lot of options and a lot of features. Some are self-exploratory, some we communicated to you. It's on you how you want to make use of it. So we request all of you to start exploring and start using this, and let us know your feedback and your requirements of customization, and we'll be happy to assist you.
Hello, I have already created a page on my that fundamental. So I would like to know, how do I refer in a very nice way? I cannot get citations. And what is the way of doing it?
Okay, you can always
because I have to write the whole name of the, you know, document. Can you check mine?
Yes. So, sir, where exactly have you created that?
In the space that you're given.
Okay. Your personal space?
Right. No, where that fundamental research group comes?
It's an NVLI at IITB. Okay. Fine. Okay. So, under FRG, you have created this page.
Right.
Okay.
So now, if you see down, I got a link to those documents.
Okay.
Now these are redundant.
Okay. These are redundant because it automatically it's maintaining the versions of these documents.
Right. Suppose I now go and edit. I can actually delete all this. I can actually delete.
No, you won't be able to delete.
Yeah, if you go down, go down.
Yes, just a second.
Just copy first and then delete. Not everything, only the last.
No,
that table.
Right, now, since I have logged in from the admin account, I will be able to delete everything.
Right.
Yes, but when you as a user will log in, you won't be able to delete.
So the question is, you see the blue thing that is being written, the text above, towards the end of the paragraph.
This.
Right.
Okay.
So you have to give a big title there. Instead of that, I would like to put it down somewhere. Say 1, 2, 3, and then say it is given in this.
Okay. Sorry, I'm not getting exactly the point. Yes. Sir, these are minor.
I will send you a mail.
Yes. These all can be taken care
Thank
of
you.
By us. Thank you everyone for spending your precious time.